Everyone seems to think the council's a good idea. Any thoughts on how we should set it up?
Yeah, conscription.
Pardon?
You just pick out who you want and ask them to report for duty. But don't turn up, you haven't shot.
I think that might defeat the purpose a bit, Ettie.
Why?
Well, you could have it like a proper election. People could nominate and have campaigns and then everyone votes on who they want.
Hey, Chucky reckons we should have champagne.
I reckon.
Oh, Lexie, I said campaign.
Yeah, well, I reckon you get more votes with champagne.
Give that to Costello. He'll give you the negatives. Of course, I know when you've got them, you'll probably try to double-cross me. But just remember, even from in here, it's not hard to put a contract out on you. If anything goes wrong with my escape, you won't have time to gloat about it. Do we understand each other?
Nana. I'm sorry I didn't come up before. I was trying to concentrate on the music. Oh, let's not go to sleep angry at each other.
Perhaps you weren't coming.
Being cautious, to make sure you were on your own.
I'm the one who should be cautious. You're the one who phoned me, remember? Thank you. Lionel sends his regards, by the way. Says he's glad you joined us on this one and hopes you'll be a member of the team.
Well, you can tell him to forget about that for a start. As soon as this business is over, I want nothing more to do with you lot.
So all that business about her having talked is a load of rubbish. She wants us to get her out, and you're to help.
It also says that you're to hand over the negatives to me.
They are the ones. We didn't have time to make prints, so you're quite safe. Now, a few questions. What time are the women let out to the exercise yard?
Weekdays. The mornings from 10 till 11. The afternoon, 3 till 4. It's the same at weekends, except it's extended till 5.
All right, security arrangements while all this is going on?
Two guards on the outer and inner gates and two officers supervising the women in the grounds. It's all very casual. There won't be any trouble.
Okay. I want you to draw me a detailed layout of the grounds. Don't miss anything. I'm going to have to set this up for tomorrow morning.
It's pretty quick, isn't it?
I don't really have much choice in the matter. I don't like it any more than you do. When you're finished here, go straight home. Now call me first thing in the morning and I'll let you know what's going to happen and when.
How can I get out of wearing this without upsetting May? Maybe I can tell her it's just for special occasions. Nora? Be quiet, love. Everything all right?
Yes, I'm all right. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I don't normally do this sort of thing.
What is it?
Oh, nothing in particular.
The baby?
I think today when it kicked was the first time I really believed it was happening. I was talking to Mrs. Morris about parole. She seems to think I've got a pretty good chance. I'm not going to get my hopes up or anything, but if I am paroled, it'll mean I'll be able to keep my baby and not have to hand her over.
Myra, I can't tell you how much that'd mean.
Hey, I know what it means. Hey, come on. Look, you got what? 5 months to go. And if you've got Meg Morris on side, there's a damn good chance everything will turn out well.
Yeah, I know. I gave up a long time ago expecting anything from life. And now this is happening. I'm scared something's going to go wrong. If it does, I don't think I'd want to bother living.
Hey, cut that talk out. Look, you're going to have a beautiful baby, and the two of you are going to be happy together. So why don't you start practicing being happy for a change?
All right. Thanks.
It's all right for some people who've got no work to do. A ladyship can lie in bed all day. Nobody makes me a cup of tea. That's right, madam. Keep me waiting. Here we are. A nice hot cup of tea.
Morning. Did you sleep well?
A little better, yes.
Good. I thought you might have been up all night framing the negatives. You did get them.
Yes, your friend Costello was most obliging. I'm sure you'll be disappointed to know that they are now a pile of ashes.
Not at all. Personally, I didn't think they were your best angle. Now let's cut the pleasantry, shall we, and get down to business. We have a contract, you and I.
Don't need reminding. Costello and his men will be here this afternoon during the exercise period. I'll get you to the fence and create enough diversion for them to get you out.
And Kelly?
She stays. I'll see to it.
Good. Well, if there's nothing else...
Oh, but there is. Desmond.
I hadn't forgotten.
Good. Because you don't move one inch out of Wentworth until she's fixed once and for all.
Patterson, Beecham and Collins. That's the laundry. Now, Ettie, cleaning duties.
Again?
Oh, I don't mind. By the time I'm finished, you'll be able to eat off these floors.
And the way Merv's cooking is, it's the best place for it.
He's love sick.
Yeah, he's in love and the food's making us sick.
Shut up, Kelly. Come on, the rest of you get out.
Miss Morris.
Ettie, how many times have I told you not to call me Meg?
Oh, I forgot. Well, you see, my memory isn't what it was. Well, come to think of it, never has been very good.
All right, what is it?
What's what?
Well, you called me.
Did I? What for?
Well, I don't know. Was it that letter to Sadie?
Oh, did she write to me?
No, you wrote to her. I posted it last night.
Oh, no, I remember. I need you to go to the bank for me.
Well, what for?
The money, of course. Oh, it's not for me. It's for young Lexie. You see, I got into trouble and I do owe her.
You know you're not allowed to have money in here.
Eh? Oh, no, to put in the bank. $5,000.
$5,000? Oh, Ettie. What are you up to this time?
Oh, it won't be a big fancy wedding or anything. You know, well, quite.
Any idea when?
Oh, it's not for another 3 months. We both got leave due then, so we might even manage a honeymoon somewhere. I fancy to eat you myself.
Oh, don't blame you. Another 3 months of Ballinger. We'll all need a holiday.
Yes, mind you, the federal police playing silly buggers seems to be working.
The women believe the newspaper report?
Aye, they swallowed it hook, line and sinker, and they're not too happy about it.
That's understandable. If they think she's capable of betraying her own organisation, they're not going to trust her to be loyal to them.
No, which is just what they're after, right?
Yes, I just hope they get the information they want and get her out of here fast before we're forced to protect her from the women.
Mm. I'll leave you to it.
Anne Reynolds. Pippa, slow down, I can't understand you.
Please, ma'am, she's in shock. Can you come straight away?
Where are you?
At the police station, please hurry.
Pippa, what's happened?
Oh, Mrs. Hartley's been killed.
Right.
Jenny's been arrested for murder.
I'll get the file from forensic and give it to me in 10 minutes. If I've got someone here, I can talk.
There we go.
Okay.
Welcome to you.
Right.
Thank you.
Our
boss. I didn't have time for any breakfast. Not that I'd have been able to keep it down, mind you. All that blood.
Yes. Must have been a big shock for you. Now, let's get this straight, Mrs. Goddard. You say that you knew as soon as you walked into that room that the girl had killed Mrs. Hartley.
I always knew it would happen. Went at each other hammer and tongs, they did.
Get all this down there, Amy.
Right.
So they had fights.
Did they? What? Many's the time I've heard them screaming at each other. Not that I listened in, mind you.
No, of course not. Go on.
Miss Jenny, she wanted to get out more, you know, have a good time. Old Mrs. Hartley, she wanted her to stay home and nurse her. Well, Miss Jenny, she got very angry. Always a bit uppity, I thought. After all, it was the old lady's money, and she thought the world of the girl.
She gave her everything she wanted, didn't she?
Oh, yes, ever since she was 9 years old. Doted on her, she did. I'm not surprised she killed her.
Surprised? Oh, Mrs. Goddard, you mean to say you're not surprised at what happened?
Well, you didn't know her, Inspector.
No.
She was a mean old... That is, she could be a very hard woman, always threatening and expecting people to fetch and carry for her and getting her own way.
Really?
14 years I worked for her, and not once did I get a Christmas box nor even a card.
Really?
Not that I expected it. But Miss Jenny, well, she was choking to death in that house. How else was she going to get away from the old lady?
Yes, of course. And they had fights yesterday?
Yes, that's right. No, wait, I'll tell a lie. Must have been the day before, because yesterday was the day Mr. Brooks came round. Oh.
Brooks? Who's Brooks?
Old lady's solicitor. He used to take care of all her money and her will and such.
He used to come round often?
Him? You must be joking. No, it had to be something very important to get him out there. I reckon he's the one you want to have a talk to.
Yes.
They won't let me see her. And if only she'd talk to me first.
Pippa, you're talking as though she did it.
You don't think she did?
I don't know. I'm certainly not going to prejudge her until I've heard the full story. Now, come on, sit down.
I knew how desperate she was. Remember when she told us Mrs. Hartley would have to be dead for her to get away?
Yes, but that's the sort of thing people say all the time. Doesn't mean anything.
Oh, it does this time, doesn't it? I heard them talking. Mrs. Goddard and the detective. Jenny had blood all over her. Apparently she bashed the old lady's head in.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Has she called a solicitor?
I don't know. They won't tell me anything.
Well, we can soon change that.
There you are, Mrs. Reynolds. Grace okayed it.
Jenny. Oh, Mrs. Reynolds. Nana's dead.
I know.
I'm afraid I have to stay, and anything that's said may be useful.
Yes. Has she seen a doctor?
She's talked to Inspector Grace. Apart from that, I really don't know.
Are you all right?
They think I killed her.
Did you kill her, Jenny?
I picked up the lamp. Her head, it was all wet. I don't remember.
Try to remember. You were alone with your grandmother. Did anyone else come into the house?
No. I was playing the piano. She knocked and knocked, but I didn't go, not till later. Then she was dead.
She knocked?
Yes. Very loudly, over and over on the ceiling above me. But she didn't call. Supposing that was when Mrs. Reynolds...
Does Grace know about this?
I don't know.
But he's going to.
I have to go now. Nana doesn't like the house being left unattended, and there's such a lot to do. The funeral, the flowers.
Not now, Jenny.
You okay? You're up half the night. I heard you.
Sorry, I didn't mean to wake you. Don't worry. Just that I've got a lot to think about. I'll be okay.
Don't upset her ladyship, Lexie. She doesn't like rude gestures.
Only she can swear like a trooper in French.
Oh, rubbish. Now, it's nothing to be ashamed of, dear. I'm glad that finishing school taught you something.
You just say these things to upset me, May. You know you do.
Now, would I do that? Now, I ask you, Myra, just because she wasted 2 years and thousands of dollars of her father's money to go to a Ponzi school that majored in intercourse with a ski instructor.
How dare you! You knew that was a secret!
Well,
Well, it isn't anymore.
Oh, don't put her on your council. You'll never know whose side she's on.
I've no intention of standing for the council, madam. Oh, but why don't you? We don't want all that foreign education and good breeding to go to waste now,
yes,
do we?
Maybe I will. At least I won't be destructive like some people. It might help my barter business. I could arrange a garbage committee.
Okay. You've been like a bear with a sore head lately.
Just because I'm not falling over backwards about your stupid bloody council.
No, it's not just that. Although you could be a little more positive about it.
What's to be positive about? What are you going to ask for? Weekends at home? An hour a day to file your nails? Stick it, I got other plans.
I know this girl.
Look, nice girls commit murder all the time, Mrs. Reynolds. Especially ones like Jennifer Hardy, who've been browbeaten most of their lives. Suddenly they can't take it anymore. Something snaps, they go berserk, and they usually end up killing someone.
All right, even if it did happen, surely the girl can't be held responsible. She wasn't in her right mind.
Unfit to plead, is that what you're saying? Not this one. Now, I'm sure the lawyers are going to try it on, but my money says she is saner than you or me.
I'm sorry, but my intuition tells me you're wrong. She heard noises from her grandmother's bedroom.
Intuition? Mrs. Reynolds, my blokes went over that place with a fine-tooth comb. We found no evidence of forced entry. No one broke in at all. The girl said so herself. What we did find was two sets of prints on the murder weapon, the victim's and Jennifer Hartley's. There are no other fingerprints in the room whatsoever. Plus, we have the best motive in the world. Money.
What are you saying?
What I'm saying, Mrs. Reynolds, is this. That just 12 hours before, I reckon Jennifer Hartley smashed her grandmother's skull in with a lamp base. The old lady changed her will, making the young girl the sole beneficiary. And believe me, I'm talking about more money than you or I will ever poke a bloody stick at.
I just can't believe it.
Oh. Well, I'm sorry about that, Mrs. Reynolds. I don't have the benefit of your woman's intuition. What I've got is a victim, a suspect, a weapon, fingerprints, and a gilt-edged motive. Now, that adds up to evidence. Evidence that's going to send that girl away for a long, long time.
This afternoon? You mean I'm going to be living like a real person tonight?
If you do what you're told, yes. Desmond has to be fixed before we go. It's part of the deal. An overdose of heroin with fingerprints on the hypo.
And how are we going to do that?
We'll take it to the shower rooms where it's quiet. Then you'll hold it down while I stick the needle in.
Wait a minute. Hold Desmond down all on my own. Look, she's pretty tough.
You can handle it.
Yeah, well, I know. It's just that I'd be a lot happier if I had Kath or else.
We're not cutting anyone else in, Lou. Now, I said you can handle it and you will. Now, we're going to be out of this hole this afternoon. Trust me.
Yeah.
But why should I apologize? I didn't start it.
You sure?
Well, I did make a bit of a mess of things. It was his special pan, you see. I offered to buy him another one, but he didn't have to get so mad at me. He was wrong, Meg. Actually, I suppose we both were.
But it doesn't matter who apologizes, as long as someone makes the first move. I mean, if you leave it any longer...
Oh, yes, of course. Of course, you're quite right. How could I have been so silly? Do you mind if I go and see him?
Of course, dear.
Oh, thanks. Oh, sorry.
Sorry, Jess.
Sorry, Dennis.
What's all that about?
I think the lover's quarrel is about to be resolved.
All right. Dear Meg, advice to the lovelorn, eh?
Wish I could solve my own problems as easily.
Oh, what's the matter now?
Patterson is about to sting Ettie for $5,000. From what I can gather, it's something to do with those silly IOUs Ettie handed out.
God, she's an enterprising little lass, isn't she?
I can't let Ettie get ripped off like that.
Well, then stop it. When Eddie's got to have someone to look out for, and you're it, I'm afraid, whether you like it or not.
Excuse me, my name's Durrant. I'd like to see Mrs. Reynolds, if I can. We're friends.
Is she back yet?
Only just, I think. I'll call her.
Anne Reynolds. Yes, all right. Show him in.
Yes, Officer Crookshank will show you through.
There you go.
Thank you.
Simon, this is a surprise. Come and sit down.
I feel a little awkward at being here, but I felt I owed you an explanation.
Oh, please, that's not necessary.
Pip's told me what happened.
Oh. Well, I'm on my way to the airport. I've managed to get a plane to London this afternoon. I've called home.
Simon, I'm really sorry for what happened.
Oh, please, Anne, you've been very kind. It's just that, well, I thought Pippa and I wanted the same things. She never said that. It just didn't occur to me.
Simon, Pippa doesn't mean to hurt people. When her father died, she was shattered and just withdrew. I hoped that London would help her to live again. Instead, she's just become superficial, I suppose.
Yes. Well, I won't take up any more of your time.
Will you go back to your family?
We'll try. My wife says she doesn't want only half of me back. I don't know how much I can give her.
You're still in your proud, Joyce.
Yes, well, we had a little upset, you see.
You sure know. Well, he just told me he hoped the cake would set things right.
He told you? But where is he? I've just been to the kitchen. He's not there.
Well, you've both been going round in circles. He landed up in reception. And, well, he had to leave, I'm afraid.
Leave?
Yeah. Had a phone call from his mother. Apparently, she's quite poorly.
Oh, no. He has been worried about her.
Mm. Well, he left you this.
Oh.
But don't worry. He said he'd be back in a day or two. Hey, look, I'll catch you later, okay?
I didn't know it was broken.
You're talking about the money, the 5,000 you were supposed to get for me, understand?
Of course I fixed it. I got Meggie to see to it. I told you I would.
Meg, you told Mrs. Morris.
Well, how else was I supposed to do it? The one at me go to the bank, not with the war on.
Bloody heck, tell the screws. I'm surprised you didn't take out an ad on telly.
I never thought of that.
Well, it's a perfect fit if I do say so myself. Is it nice and warm, dear?
Perfect, love. Just what I've always wanted.
It suits you, dear. I expect it's comfortable, too.
Well, I wouldn't know myself.
Well, who's to blame for that, dear?
You look pale, Nora. Are you all right, dear?
I'm fine. Of course you are, dear. Look, I'll get some small needles and start knitting you a layette.
Thanks, May, but I'm hoping Bub and I will be well and truly on the outside by the time it's born.
You'll make it. Of course you will, love. Willie, what is the matter?
Oh, she's still punishing me for what I said this morning.
It's got nothing to do with you, even though you cut me to the quick. It's Nora. She's so brave. Haven't you got any heart?
As much as you have, madam.
Okay, you two cut it out. Oh, I'm sorry. I just keep thinking of that poor, fatherless little baby with no one in the world to turn to.
My baby will have me, Willie. That's all that counts.
You see how brave you are? You hear about single mothers all the time. They can't get a job. They've got no money. Then the welfare comes and takes their babies away. It's dreadful.
Nora, please. Oh, you can't blame her for being a
heartless, heartless women in the world, Willie Beecham.
You have all the sensitivity of a water buffalo in a stampede. Do you ever think before you open your bloody mouth?
What have I done? I was only trying to help.
Oh, pigs and cut the crocodile's ears. If you've got any heart, it's made of pure bloody lead.
So you picked the lamp up and then you put it down again?
Yes.
Was that before or after you smashed the old lady's skull in?
After. I don't know. I didn't do it.
No. She committed suicide, right? She smashed her own bloody skull in. Come on. Why didn't you call the police or call some help?
I don't know. Please, I want to see my solicitor.
He's outside.
You'll see your solicitor before the committal proceedings. Besides, we haven't finished with you yet, girlie.
Oh, please, no more.
Come on, we know that you hated the old bitch, didn't you?
No. We fought. But I loved her.
Then why did you kill her?
She wouldn't let me be free. No way, I didn't do it.
Come on, you got her to change the will so you'd get all the bloody money. Then you plan on killing her and you leave for Japan. We know all that.
No. I wanted to go to Japan, but I didn't know about the money. I thought she was cutting me out of a will.
Oh,
I swear.
Come on. I don't believe a bloody word of it. Get her out. Okay.
No, please listen. I loved her. I couldn't have killed her.
Come on out. Printer, charge her with murder.
Now, you do understand, Nora, don't you? It's not in my hands. The parole board makes a decision.
I know that, Mrs. Reynolds, but you can recommend, can't you? Mrs. Morris says you can.
Yes, I can.
That's why I wanted to see you. I have to get out, Mrs. Reynolds. I owe it to my baby. I don't want her to be born in prison.
I've made some inquiries. There are several hostels willing to take Nora in, and there is a chance of some part-time work, but that's not settled yet.
You two seem to have it all worked out.
Oh, Mrs. Morris didn't do anything wrong. I asked her to help.
It's all right, Nora. We're here to help all of you. It's just that we don't often get the opportunity to do something positive.
Mrs. Reynolds, I don't have to be reminded of what I've done, but I've given 23 years of my life to pay for it. I'm not that person anymore.
No, I don't think you are.
This baby means everything to me. It's my chance to give back a life. I promise I'll love her and cherish her, only I can't do it in here. Please, Mrs. Reynolds.
Sit down, Nora. Now, I can't promise you what the board will decide, but yes, I can make a recommendation. And I hope that they'll be impressed by the fact that when you were on the run for 3 months, you managed to get a job, a secure place to live, and to all intents and purposes, you were living a normal life. So perhaps you won't have to have your baby in Wentworth after all.
Thank God. The baby. I just felt it move. I think she knows. Oh, thank you, Mrs. Reynolds, from both of us.
Something, Patterson?
Oh, I just fancied a smoke. Didn't think you'd mind.
Really?
Yeah, well, it's been so long since I've had bar up, I've forgotten what it's like.
Don't ever touch my things again.
Hey, I wanted to tell you, I got myself a steak for when I get out. $5,000.
Congratulations, you'll need it.
Yeah, well, I thought it'd help me until you found a spot for me.
Me?
Yeah, you and Mr. Ballinger. You said you could find a place for me in your organisation.
Oh, Lexie. I don't think we'd ever be that desperate. You see, you can't take orders.
Oh, yes, I can.
Don't interrupt me. I warned you about the grass, and then you let that stupid old woman find it. And then the screws moved in. On the outside, it could have been the police. We just couldn't afford you. Now remember, next time you want to see me, you knock.
She didn't promise anything, but she seems to think they'll let me out.
Oh, that's great, love. It certainly is, love.
Start believing the screws and you'll believe anybody.
Shut up, Kelly.
At least it's something to hope for.
Go on.
I still don't see why I should.
Look, madam, I apologise to you. Now it's your turn. Go on.
All right, don't rush me.
Nora. Well, personally, I don't think it pays to be too thin-skinned in a place like this, but... Well, if I've said anything to upset you, I can't imagine what. I'm sorry.
Doesn't matter, Willie. It wasn't your fault.
There you are.
I said it wasn't.
Oh, watch out, you stupid bitch! All right, you do it! Rack off, I'm doing this. Look! Just leave me alone, all right?
Well, whatever it is, don't take it out on us.
Oh, you wouldn't understand.
You're not making it easy.
Yeah, well, why should I? I'm sick of being kicked around and treated like an idiot. I don't have to take that from anyone, no matter who they are. I'm past being sucked in by people.
Now, hold on a minute, madam.
Oh, give it a rest, will you?
Oh, Lexie, did you see Mrs. Morris?
Why?
She asked where you were.
Oh, terrific.
Golden moment from the fun-filled factory.
Just don't underestimate Ferguson. She's bright, real bright. I've got a lot of time for that lady. I offered her a job once. I tried to set up some rackets in Wentworth. She blackmailed me right out of business.
Sounds like she could be useful. Wouldn't do any harm to have someone on the inside.
Let's just get Ruthie out first, eh? Now, you've gone over the whole job.
We've got a full 2 minutes before the smoke bomb hits. There should be plenty of time. And those bolt cutters all go through the fence like butter.
Okay. Let's just hope Ruthie's on the ball inside. From the note that old lady brought round, it looks like the feds are really putting on the pressure.
I don't like it. I told Arnie that. I just don't like it. It'd be much better if she sat tight until the trial.
But he said get her out, so we get her out.
I am just saying I don't like it.
Look, mate, you want to argue with him? Big-time lawyer or not, you're not above getting a bullet in the back of the head.
I take your point.
Oh, sorry. Just a minute. We've got something to discuss.
Oh, I've got to go and collect from Attendee.
It'll wait. Now, there's a little matter of $5,000 I'd like to clear up.
Geez, did you win the lottery or something?
Ow! Certainly like a fool, Lexie. We both know what I'm talking about. Now, you kept that IOU of Ettie's.
No.
Yes. Now, the rest of us had the decency to throw them away, but you. You're trying to exploit an old lady.
Oh, so what? She's got stacks of dough. She won't miss it. It's dog eat dog out there, and I've got to look after myself.
I want that IOU, Patterson.
Go jump.
I'll give you 5 minutes, or I'll lock you in the pound on enough trumped-up charges you'll be there a week.
You wouldn't.
Try me. Take it. It's not bloody fair. How come everybody else gets a break? I got my parole coming up, and I needed that money. Now, you listen to me. I have never spoiled a prisoner's chance of parole in my life. But if you try to rip off Ettie in any way, I swear to you, I will go before that parole board personally and make sure you never get out. And do you know, she had the gall to look me straight in the face and tell me she knew nothing about it.
Well, that was a mistake. I mean, she's obviously never seen you with a bee in your bonnet before. Well, money's on you, Lice.
Well, you'd win, because I tore the damn thing up in front of her face and made enough threats to really scare her. She won't be bothering Ettie again.
Well, good for you. I can see I'm going to have to behave myself. Otherwise, I'd be out with the rolling pin.
Oh, Dennis!
Oh, don't hit me! No,
oh,
no,
God,
no!
No, please, oh, God!
Answer that.
Hello? Yes, no, I can find that out for you.
Sure?
She's pretty cut up, poor kid. Go easy, will you?
Yes, of course.
Look, I'll do it. I'll get back to you. I think we stopped up here, all right? Yeah, I'll find it out and get back to you as soon as I can. Hang on.
Ah.
What?
Jennifer? Please, I must go home. Nana.
Oh. Come along, Jennifer. Just want you to stand on this white line over here.
Oh, yeah. What's she doing?
Murder. You wouldn't pick it, would you?
Now, I'm going to ask you a few questions, and all you have to do is answer yes or no.
Oh, please, I don't belong here. I want my Nana.
Now, your name is Jennifer Elise Hartley.
I didn't do anything. Oh, God. I didn't do it.
And if I am elected, I promise more free trade within the prison.
Yeah, as long as you get all the profits.
Some of us are called to serve, and others can only stand and make rude remarks. Besides, it wasn't my idea.
Well, don't look at me, Councillor Beecham.
Oh, just shut up! I'm sick of it all day long. If you two hate each other so much, why don't you just kill each other and give us a bit of peace?
Oh, first sensible thing you've said all day.
Cut it out, both of you.
Don't cry, Willie, love. Well, whatever gave you the idea we hate each other? You did, you stupid old cow!
See,
and I don't need you to quit your smoking either.
I said, knock it off.
I'm not taking orders from anyone. Who needs you and your stupid bloody councils? I look after me, and that's the way I like it.
All right, cut it out.
Didn't I just tell you I'm not taking orders from you? You can all go to hell because I don't want to know.
Now, that's enough.
Let go, you rotten...
Cut out the tantrums. You're too old for them, and we're sick and tired of them.
Oh, you think you're such a big shot, don't you? Well, you don't impress me. I wouldn't vote for you if you were the last person on earth.
All right, floor show's over. Let's get back to work.
Hey, you okay, love?
What does it matter? Nobody cares anyway.
That's silly, Daphne. Everybody cares about you.
I may be dumb, Nora, but I know when people don't like me. You and Myra roused on
me. Look, love, it's because we care about you that we were a bit hard on you.
I thought you were my friend.
Oh, we are. We don't want anything bad to happen to you. Myra's trying to help you. She wants to make sure you don't do anything silly with drugs again. That's why she hit you. Do you understand?
I don't know. All I know is I may as well be dead.
Daphne, all right?
Not really. She's convinced she hasn't got a friend in the world. And she thinks you hate her.
Great. First Lexie, now Daphne. Can't take a trick, can I?
You'll have a cell to yourself in your own clothes. That should make things a little bit easier.
I just want to go home. When can I leave?
Sit down for a minute, Jenny. Jenny, you can't go home. I'm sorry, but bail's refused. Your solicitor told you that.
I didn't understand. You mean I have to stay here until the trial?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Oh, but you could help me. You're a friend. You could tell them it's all a terrible mistake.
I'm afraid I can't, Jenny. The evidence is all against you. Are you sure you remember everything?
I don't know. Everybody says I killed her, but how could I? I loved her, you know that. I went to her room. I just don't remember. I couldn't have killed her and not remember, could I?
I honestly don't know, Jenny. Perhaps by the time of the trial.
Oh, you don't believe me. I thought you were my friend.
I am, but I'm also Governor of Wentworth, Jenny. Now, please try to understand. If the women knew we were friends, they could make things very difficult for you. So for both our sakes, it's better if you try to accept the fact that you are a prisoner here and I have to treat you as such. I'm sorry.
Shift just as they would on the outside. Of course, that won't affect you, not whilst you're on remand.
If I could just have my music, I'll die without it.
Oh, there's a piano in the rec room. I'm sure you'll get time to practice it. Here we are.
I don't understand. The other women, you mean I'm to be locked up on my own?
It's only for 24 hours. It's just routine. Just want to make sure you settle in, that's all.
Please, Mrs. Morris, don't put me in there. My grandmother's dead. Don't shut me up on my own. I swear I won't hurt anyone.
Oh, it's not that. Believe me. Come on, there's nothing to be afraid of.
You think I'll hurt myself, don't you? That's why you took away my pantyhose and my belt.
Hartley, you're only making things worse. Now, it isn't easy coming to a place like this. How well you survive depends on you. Don't make it any more difficult than it already is.
Do you want a cup?
I'll get it.
You know, I swear, one of these days, I'll bring in a pot and make a proper brew.
What? Right. Miss out on all that jiggling? This is modern technology.
Oh, well, it isn't tea. I tell you, my mother used to brew it so thick, your teaspoon would stand up in it. And that would get you going, I tell you.
It's a wonder it didn't rot your stomach. Oh, I've had a lousy day.
Here. This will put you right. Get rid of the knots.
Oh, yes, that's lovely. Oh, I knew there was some reason why I loved you.
All right. Better?
Much.
Hey, don't be cheeky. You're not still worried about Ettie, are you?
No, I'm just thinking about that poor Hartley girl. She's just so numb.
You think she did it?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. Must be dreadful for Anne, though, because Jennifer went to school with Pippa.
Yes, I heard, but I wouldn't worry. Anne's too much of a professional to let that bother her. I'll tell you what, I've got something to cheer you up. How about we take a couple of hours one day this week, do a bit of shopping?
Shopping?
Oh, I don't want anybody saying I'm too mean to buy you a ring.
Well, there's no hurry, is there? I mean, we can wait.
Hey, you're not going cold on me, are you?
No, I just think you need time to think about it.
So I don't need time. I know what I'm doing.
Do you? I know why you stayed with Doris for so long. You know I can never have a family.
Meg, if you're asking me to choose between you and a family, there's no contest. I want you. That's all that matters. My mind is made up, and believe me, once a Yorkshireman does that, he's bloody pig-headed.
And that's what I'm rapidly finding out.
Oh, hell, God, I should be in reception. Look, start thinking about that ring, eh? Personally, I think diamonds are a little bit vulgar.
Talk
about the ballot. It will be a secret, won't it?
Oh, yes, anything you want.
Much better when I'm outside.
I know you are.
Hey, do you want to come out and look at my plants?
I'd love it. I've got something for you.
Yeah, what is it?
This!
Oh, God! Nora!
What happened?
Oh, get help! Oh, baby!
Please,
you're
get help, Daphne!
Me?
Get Myra quickly, nobody else. We don't want trouble with
her. Myra, right?
No buts, do exactly what I say. Get Myra quickly!
Baby, please! Oh, baby!
Well, what have we got here?
Come on, Bellinger, help me get her on her feet.
Don't let me.
Son! Of course not! We'll get you to sister.
All right, away. Come on.
Can't you get any closer?
Not without being seen.
You know what to do. But the minute you see Ruth Ballinger, let me know. You've got 5 minutes.
No worries.
I'll be glad when this is over.
Myra! Oh, you've got to come quick. It's Nora, she's been hurting the babies.
Shh, okay, calm down. Mr. Crookshank, I sent Daphne to find my cigarettes, but she couldn't. Do you mind if I have a look?
Oh, no, yes, of course. You don't have to go out, you know.
No, I won't be long. Daphne, you go and get some fresh air.
You don't look so upset. I should find him. Hey, it's not the end of the world, you know.
Yeah, I guess so. I've got to go and look at my plants now. Nora? Nora? You see Nora? Daphne said she was hurt.
Oh, yes, the little mother. Daphne's a panic merchant. Flynn complained of stomach pains. Probably the little brat making its presence felt. Anyway, she went to the toilet. I'm sure she'd be quite happy to have you hold her hand.
By God, you are a bitch.
Well, I think we might be in luck. No real damage done.
But I'm getting pains.
Well, they're not contractions.
Flynn says she fell over. That'd cause some pain, surely.
Oh, yes.
Damn it, you're a nurse, not a doctor. This is my baby we're talking about. I'm not going to lose it because of you.
Watch your mouth, Flynn.
Oh, it's all right, Miss Ferguson. Look, Flynn, if you're really that worried, perhaps we should have a doctor look at you.
Thank you.
Look, I've left the women unattended. I'll get back to them.
Of course. Still don't think the pains are contractions.
Please, just call a doctor.
Nora, you're... Oh, easy, Lou.
We don't want any telltale bruises. People might ask questions.
Nora, what happened to her?
She's okay. If she wasn't, it wouldn't be any great loss.
You bitch!
We're not having a good day, are we? Hold her tighter, Kelly.
Oh, Ferguson, you mongrel!
You're just in time.
I wouldn't have missed it for the world.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the night. is here our prisoners too.